हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। मायसेल्फ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर संतोष नपते, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी, संभाजीराव केंद्रीय महाविद्यालय जळगाव। फ्रेंड्स, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ बैक्टीरियल ग्रोथ एंड रिप्रोडक्शन, एंड इन दैट वी हैव स्टडीड हाउ दिस बैक्टीरिया दे ग्रोस और दे रिप्रोड्यूसेस by binary fission, and then we have seen about the generation time, that is concept of generation time, and we have seen the generation times of different bacteria. Now in today's lecture we will see about the different stages in bacterial growth curve, because when you inoculate that particular number of bacteria in a liquid growth medium, then it is possible to design or to plot a bacterial growth curve. And this bacterial growth curve, it shows the growth of cells taking place over a time. Means after inoculation of that bacteria into a liquid nutrient medium, now that nutrients medium get available to the bacteria, and that bacteria, they can grow or they can multiply. So how this bacterial growth takes place in that nutrient media, that is, or that can be studied with the help of this growth curve. And this bacterial growth curve, simply it shows how the growth of that bacteria is taking place over a time. So there are four basic phases of growth, because this bacterial growth curve, it is divided into different phases. It means whatever that growth of that bacteria is taking place in a nutrient medium, it is takes place in four different stages or four different phases. The first phase is here, that is called as lag phase. Second one is here log, actually this lag phase, it is also called as the initial phase of growth curve or initial phase of bacterial growth. Second one is here log phase, which is also called as exponential phase. Third one is stationary phase, and the fourth phase of that bacterial growth curve, it is called as death phase. So in this way, that growth curve of bacteria, it consists of four basic phases. Which are that four basic phases? First one, lag phase, or which is also called as the initial phase. Second one, log phase, or which is also called as exponential phase. Third one is stationary phase, and fourth one is the death phase. So friends, one by one we are going to see all these four phases. So let's start the first phase, that is, so here this bacterial growth curve, so that is the, or that is studied in the batch culture. So closed system, then bacteria grown in a liquid medium, because when you inoculate this bacteria in a liquid medium, which is called as broth, so that may be nutrient broth, that may be McConkie's broth, but generally broth medium or broth, it is means liquid. So single batch medium, and nutrient get exhausted, and there is a decline in the growth of bacteria, because after completion of that nutrition, so or after exhausting of that nutrients, automatically there is a decrease in the growth of bacteria takes place. And when a graph is plotted as the logarithm of the number of viable cells versus the incubation time, so on y-axis there will be number of viable cells, and on x-axis there will be incubation time or the time required for the growth of bacteria. So see, this is the that graph or which shows the stages or phases of the growth curve. See here, this is the logarithm of the viable cells. So these are the number of viable cells here, and here these are the time in hours in this case here. So 5 hours, 10 hours, 15 hours. So this is the time in hours. So here this indicates few cells, that is faint blue you can see here. So these are the few cells. Then this indicates live cells, these are the live cells here, and this pink color, it indicates the dead cells. So at this stages, so at the first stage here, that is that, see, this is the growth curve of bacteria here, which consists of four phases. One is lag phase, that is initial phase. Actually, this lag phase, it is a straight here, like this here, like one. Okay, so lag phase, then later on exponential growth phase, or which is called as log phase, then stationary phase, and then later on in final stages, there is a decrease in the number of viable cells. So that is called as death phase. Okay, and at the end of this growth curve here, or that time, that some cells, they remain viable. So that is indicated here in the dark blue color here. So that some cells, they remain viable, but many cells, there is the death of that cells takes place, and that's why this is called as death phase. So here, so this is about the that is called as growth curve of bacteria, which consists of four phases. Now I will going to explain about all these four phases here. So the next one is here, or the first phase of growth curve is the lag phase, or it is called as initial phase of the growth curve. That is the first phase of this growth curve, and when you inoculate that microorganisms into a fresh medium, so after inoculation of that microorganisms into that fresh medium, now these microorganisms, they are new to that particular environment, that is of nutrient medium. So that's why these bacteria, they will try to adjust, or they will try to adapt to that nutrients, or to that new environment. And so that's why that bacteria, they will require some time to multiply or to start their replication, because they are new to that environment, or they are new to that nutrient medium, and that's why they will take some time to adapt or to adjust that nutrients. So that's why there is no immediate increase in the number of cells, or there is no increase in the net mass of that bacterial cells. So that number of microorganisms, it will remain same for some time. So for example, if you are inoculating 1000 bacterial cells in that nutrient medium, so this 1000 number of that bacterial cell, it will remain same for some time. Why? Because these bacteria, they are trying to adjust that new environment. So that's why that number of this bacteria, that will remain same for some time. So this lag phase, it is a phase which is preparing to grow in size and synthesize different types of enzymes. So that cell is synthesizing their own components, and that can be vary, that is short or even absent. So what are the importance of this lag phase? So these bacterial cells, they may be old and depleted of ATP, because there is no energy source will be there. There is no essential cofactors, ribosomes, and these must be synthesized before the growth of that bacteria will begins. Now the medium may be the different than the previous one, so enzymes are required, because you are inoculating that bacteria, you are taking this bacteria from another nutrient media or from culture tubes, and you are inoculating this bacteria into new nutrient medium. So that's why the medium in which you are inoculating that bacteria, it is different as compared to previous environment. So that's why that bacteria, they will require many enzymes to start their multiplication, to start their growth, and possibly their number of injured and require some time to recover. So these microorganisms, they have been injured, and that's why they will require some time to recover. So that's why the number of that microorganisms, it will remain same. There will be no new microorganisms in this first phase, which is called as lag phase, or which is the first phase of the growth curve. Now this was, so that's why in this graph here, see, this is the number of bacteria, it will remain same. Actually this is showing increase, but the number or the graph will be remain same here, like this straight line, that is parallel to this x-axis. So that means there is no increase in the number of bacteria, but once these bacteria, they get adjusted to that new environment, that means they enter in the second phase of that growth curve, and that second phase, it is called as log phase, or it is also called as exponential phase. It is also known as exponential phase, and in this exponential phase, the growth and division is at maximal rate. So in this lock phase, because in first phase all these microorganisms, they get adjusted to the new environment. Now they are ready to multiply very fast, or they are ready to grow or ready to divide very fast, and that's why the growth as well as division or multiplication of these microorganisms in the second phase, it is at the maximum rate. And it is also called as the balanced growth, since all these cells, the constituents are synthesized at the constant rate. So whatever the different components are to be synthesized in that bacterial cell or by that bacterial cell, that are synthesizing at a constant rate. And that's why this log phase, it is also called as the phase of balanced growth. So the population number of cells it is undergoing by binary fission, which doubles at a constant interval, which is called as generation time. So we have seen that bacteria, they can multiply, they can divide by a binary fission, in which that number of bacterial cells, they get doubled at a particular interval. And this time or duration in which the number of bacterial cells become doubles, that is called as generation time. We have seen the definition of this generation time and some examples in last lecture. So you can watch that video also. So continue as long as cells have adequate nutrients and good environment. So this log phase will be continued till there is a availability of sufficient nutrients as well as optimum environment for that bacterial cells. And all studies related to their various properties are done in this log phase, because the bacterial cells or that microorganisms, they are very active metabolically in this log phase, and that's why whatever that studies is done or research is done on that bacterial cells, it is done in this log phase, or it is done when that bacterial cells are in log phase. See, these are the examples of exponential growth here, because the rate of division, it is optimum or maximum in this second phase. For example, at time 0, the division number will be 0 here, and 2^n, for example, it is 0, and that's why the population of that bacteria or number of that bacteria will be 1 here. Okay, so after specific generation, the total population will be 1. Now after time 20 minutes, so for example here the generation time is 20 minutes. Now after 20 minutes, so first generation will be here, that is number of division 1. So then 2^1 means 2, so that population becomes double here in 20 minutes. So that's why this 20 minutes, it is the generation time, and the population will become, total population will become 2. Then after 40 minutes, how many generations or divisions are taking place here? 2 divisions are taking place. So that's why 2^2 means 4. Again, see here, the population becomes double. So here 1, the population becomes double after 1 generation, that become 2. The population become again double at second after 2 generations, so it will become 4, and total population will be 4. Then after 60 minutes, then so divisions or number of divisions will be 3, that means 2^3 means 8. So again that population becomes double of this previous generation, and total population will be 8. Then after 80 minutes, number of divisions 4, so 2^4 means 16, number of bacterial cells will be here, again that population becomes double, so total population will be 16 cells or microorganisms. After 100 minutes, 5 generations will be there, so 2^5 means 32 cells will be there, so that population becomes double and total population will be 32. And after 120 minutes, that is after 6 divisions, so the total population will become 64, that means the population again get doubled here, that is 32, it get doubled 64, and total population will be 64. So in this way, the exponential growth or that bacteria in log phase, they can grow in this way. So that is called as the exponential growth, because the rate of division of bacteria in this exponential phase, it will be very rapid or it will be very fast. Okay, so here we will see that demonstration of the balanced and unbalanced growth. So one is the shift up experiment, and another one is the shift down experiment. So shift up experiment, in which that bacteria, when they get transferred from nutritionally poor medium to richer medium, then the lag phase is longer, because that bacteria, they are metabolically inactive when they are present in nutritionally poor medium, and when we will transfer these bacteria into nutritionally rich medium, so then these bacteria, they will require more time to adjust that new environment, and that's why the lag phase is longer. Okay, second one is here, shift down experiment. So in this case, that bacteria, when they are transferred from nutritionally rich medium to poor medium, then the lag phase is shorter. Why this is happening? Because when that bacteria, they are present in nutritionally rich medium, then these are metabolically, or they are highly metabolically active. Okay, and when they are transferred to nutritionally poor medium, so they are already in an active state, and that's why they are easily adjust to that new environment. So that's why the duration of this lag phase, it is shorter in case of this shift down experiment. Okay, so the third phase is here, that is stationary phase. So this is the next phase of the growth curve, which is called as stationary phase, and as the name suggests here, as a stationary, so the number of, or the reproduction rate, it is balanced by the death rate, and that's why the population of bacteria, it remains the stationary, or it remains the constant. Okay, and there is an exhaustion. Now why this is happening, why the there is a balance between the death rate and the populations of that bacteria, or why there is a constant population of that bacteria? So this is due to the exhaustion of nutrients and accumulation of some toxic materials in the nutrient medium. Okay, because that bacteria, they are growing very fastly in the second phase, that is in logarithmic phase, and that's why they will utilize more and more nutrients. So at the end of this logarithmic phase, that is at the end of second phase, there will be exhaustion of some nutrients, and at the same time, due to the metabolic activities of that microorganisms, there is a possibility of accumulation of some toxic materials. So that's why there is a balance between the death rate and the population. Okay, so in this stage, that microbial death is equal to microbial growth. Okay, so the death rate as well as growth rate, it is equal or it is same, and that is called as the period of equilibrium. So the metabolic activity of surviving cells, it gets slows down, which stabilizes the population, because now there is a deficiency, or there is a exhaustion of some nutrients in the stationary phase, and that's why the metabolic activity of these cells which are surviving, the metabolic activity, it slows down, and this decrease in the metabolic activity, it is responsible for the stabilization of the population, which remains constant. And the cause of discontinuity of exponential growth, it is not always clear, and it may play a role. So exhaustion of nutrients, then accumulation of waste products, and there is a changes in pH also takes place, which is harmful to the bacterial cell. Okay, so that chemostat culture or method is used here, that is a continuous culture, and it is used in industrial fermentations. So what is the possible reasons for the entry into stationary phase? So why these microorganisms, they are entering into stationary phase? So the different reasons are, one includes nutrient limitation, because in second phase, that is in logarithmic phase, that bacteria, they are metabolically very active, and that's why they utilize more and more nutrients. So there is a nutrient limitation will be there during the stationary phase. Then limited oxygen availability, then toxic waste accumulation because of metabolic activity in second phase, that is in logarithmic phase, and critical population density reached. So these are reasons why these bacteria, they are entering into stationary phase. Okay, so we can see the diagram again here. See this diagram, exponential growth phase, the rate of division, it is very high. See here, so at its maximum rate, and after that, due to the exhaustion of nutrients from that nutrient media and accumulation of toxic substances. So there is a death rate and growth rate will be equal, and that's why the population of that bacteria remains the constant here. So that's why this is the stationary phase here. There is no decrease in population or there is no further increase in the population, but that population remains constant. Okay, and after that there is a decrease in the population takes place here, that is called as death phase, that we will see. So we have seen these possible reasons why that bacteria they are entering into stationary phase. That means one is nutrient limitation, second one is limited oxygen availability, third one is toxic waste accumulation, and fourth one is critical population density reached. So these are the reasons why these bacteria they are entering into stationary phase. So the fourth one or the last phase of that growth curve, it is called as death phase. So in this death phase, there is a decline in the number of viable cells taking place. Again, we will see this diagram here. See this one. There is a decline in the number of viable cells taking place here. See here, all these viable cells are present here. See this dark blue, it is indicating viable cells. But in stationary phase, there are number of viable cells is decreasing, and later on, there is a more decrease in the death phase. So the death rate will be more in this death phase or decline phase. It is also called as decline phase, and it is indicated by this. So these dead cells, it is indicated by this pink color here. So there is a more, so that cells, there is a decline in the number of viable cells taking place here, and these cells, they are dying usually at the exponential rate or at the more speed or fast rate. So that death, it is due to the loss of ability to reproduce, because when that cells now they are entering into death phase, so there is a loss of ability to reproduce or to divide takes place, and that's why that bacteria they get killed or they get died. But in some cases that death rate it is slows due to the accumulation of resistant cells, because there are some bacterial cells are also present which are resistant, and that's why the death rate will be slow, and it is slower than log phase. It is also called as the logarithmic decline phase, because whatever that death is occurring of that cells here, it is in the logarithmic manner, so fast. So that's why it is called as logarithmic decline phase. Okay, and this death phase, it will continues until a small fraction of the population is diminished. Then some population dies out completely, and some population it retains surviving cells, while others only retain for few days. So that's why during death phase also there are some bacteria which remain viable. See here. Okay, but maximum population it will be killed because of accumulation and toxic substances here. So this is the death phase. Now what are the characteristics of death phase? So there is a nutrient deprivation or deficiency, then toxic material get accumulated, then there is a irreversible loss of the ability to reproduce, that means that bacteria cannot reproduces, then the death can be logarithmic and it can vary with environmental conditions such as growth medium which is used and the microorganisms which are involved. Then there is a development of resistant bacteria, and that's why they show the extended survival of that particular bacteria, and generally these bacteria they die in a log phase. Okay, that means there is a death of that bacteria taking place in a fast way or in a high speed. See, this is the again that graph here in few characteristics here. For example, lag phase, which is the initial phase, there is no increase in the number of living bacterial cells. So why there is no increase in the number of living bacterial cells? Because these bacteria they require some time to adjust that new environment. So that's why there is no increase in the number of living bacterial cells. But once they get adjusted to that new environment, then they divide very fast or they divide rapidly, and that's why there is a rapid increase in the number of bacterial cells. That is called as log phase, or it is called as exponential growth phase. See here, there is an exponential increasing number of living bacterial cells. So the metabolic activity is very high in the second phase, and that bacteria they divide very fastly. Okay, later on in third stage, so the population number remains the constant here. see here. So that is called as stationary phase, and it is the third phase of growth curve. So that plateau in a number of living bacterial cells, the rate of cell division and rate of death, it is roughly equal. So that's why that graph will be remain stationary, or that population number will be constant. That is called as stationary phase. Then death phase or decline phase. So see here, there is a decrease in the number of bacterial cells. Why this is happening? So this is, that means there is an exponential decrease in the number of living bacterial cells. So this is because of deficiency of nutrients, accumulation of toxic materials. So, and that bacteria, they lose their ability to reproduce, or they lose their ability to divide, and that's why the number of viable cells goes on decreasing here. Okay, so this is about the bacterial growth curve in a simple way. So next lecture we will see about the measurement of microbial growth, how the microbial growth can be measured, which are the different instruments. So that we will see in next lecture, friends. So don't forget to like, comment and share this video, and if you are not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, then kindly subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching.